Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to this interactive session. In the last session, Dr. Sameer Sahasrabuddhi had talked about visual communication skills. And I hope all of you got a good idea about things to be checked while doing presentations. I also think that the peer review process that was done locally would have given you some idea about the review process. We had done one informal peer review in the discussion forum in the week one, where we had asked each of you to evaluate the course journal, upload the course journal, and rate each other's course journal in the discussion forum. So now in the morning, there were several doubts in the morning and in yesterday's sessions. Several people had asked doubts regarding the way the discussion forum is structured and how to navigate effectively in the discussion forum. So I have a small presentation for you which will help you in understanding how the discussion forum is structured in FDP 101X. After this explaining the discussion forum, I'll be taking questions from clarifications from each of the remote center. So let me start the session. So it is about utilizing discussion forum. So the structure of discussion forum is something like this. On the top left hand menu, you will have several tabs or several substructures which you can actually access to identify a discussion that was happening in a specific topic. So for example, in the current FDP, we have discussion forums of the form LXI course journal, LXI web presence, and we also had LXI about learning management systems. There is also a general, forum. And there are some, so there is also another subdivision known as queries, where you can post the queries that you have, and we will try to answer it. So all you have to do is, in the discussion forum, on the top left, all you have to do is click on it. Then you will see the structure that is coming down. Now, there was another question about finding your own post. So one way of looking at is using the search bar and typing your username, the IIT Bombay X username in that particular search bar. So what will happen is you will see that there is a window will come which asks you show post by a particular user. If you click on this username, then you will see all the posts made by this user. Also, the search results can be structured or can be accessed as unread, unanswered, and flagged. Also, you can sort the discussion forum based on most recent activities by most activities. That means a post which has maximum activity. So, for example, in this FDP, the post introduce yourself has a maximum number of people responding to it. And there is also something known as most votes. So this is, these are posts where you actually upvote the post because the content or the description provided in the post is helpful for you. Now, identifying these kind of posts will be helpful for the instruction team to understand who all are posting good discussions and are engaging in it. Next, it is about upvoting. So every post on the top right hand side of the post, when somebody creates, there is an option for upvoting and following. So this star button is for following. So whenever you follow the post, so as you see in the first window, you can see this post I am following. So you click on star where important posts that you want to follow, then when you click on this post I am following, all these posts will come beneath it based on the search criteria, like whether it is based on recent posts, most activity, or most votes. Let me now take questions from different participants, the remote centers. I will, so if you have questions, please raise your hand so that I can find it over here. So Supreme Knowledge Foundation Group, RC1343.
So in the morning session, a gentleman had asked you a question. That is ICT invading teachers' space, right?
Yes.
So we could not get your answer because we could not get your answer over here. So
okay.
Could you come back with the answer once again?
Okay. So thank you for the question. So the question is, somebody in the morning session had asked about ICT's intrusion or invasion into teachers' teaching learning process. Now, let me give you a straight answer, an indirect answer to this question. ICT provides advantages like efficiency in terms of teaching learning delivery, and it also helps in scaling up the existing teaching learning process. Now, if this is done carefully, looking at the way in which ICT features can be used in general teaching learning, then a teacher can control the level of intrusion of ICT into their own teaching learning. It's just like Professor Fatak yesterday explaining about the 25th, the mythical 25th hour of Professor Isaac. Provided you do things carefully in an organized manner, then there is always benefit for the for any technology that you want in your regular teaching learning process. I hope I have clarified the answer.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, you did.
Thank you. So I'll now move to the next remote center. This is RC1259, Samaj's KBT College of Engineering, Nashik.
How to know the information about visitors to our web page?
Okay, the question is how to know the information about visitors to our web space, be it WordPress or other utilities. So the answer to it, there are widgets which will actually look at website hits and website counts. There are several people who use different methods, let's say Google Analytics, widget for website count. There are multiple ways of doing the same thing, but in WordPress you will get this particular information as a widget itself. Now let me go to 1101.
I appreciate first of all your way of conduct the interaction.
Thank you.
Okay, my question is an extension question which is asked in the earlier morning session.
Okay.
From NEMES. It was regarded with the effective learning teaching in the laboratory.
Okay.
So you answered that particular question by saying that it can be left to discretion of an instructor.
Okay.
This is what the answer that you give.
Yes.
So I just have an extension question which can be a thought provoking. Where can we have the facility given by IIT Mumbai or IIT Bombay in the form of virtual lab? Like virtual lab is a facility which is being given for the conduct of experiments.
Yes.
So can we have the blend of that facility into this ICT?
Okay. So
is it feasible? I mean.
Okay. So let me rephrase the question. So can the question is can the FDP have or the FDP on ICT have facilities of virtual labs as part of the regular teaching learning curriculum of the FDP? So the answer is yes, it can have. However, what happens in a large scale program is that we need to cater to the diverse audience that is available in the FDP. So virtual labs by themselves are doing a lot of workshops. So you can contact the virtual labs team. Who will be able to, I think who will be able to happy to help you out in workshops, setting up workshops for the faculty. So if you look at the FDP audience, you have a variety of audience ranging from engineering to arts and science and even law. Now a concept like virtual labs may not be suitable for such a diverse audience, and hence it has not been included in the current FDP. However, if we have, let's say, domain focused FDPs, then we will definitely consider use of virtual labs. Let me now go to 1281 SVER College.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
I want to ask a question regarding the course journal.
Okay.
So we have seen your first lecture in a first week, and you said that the structure of the course journal and the representation or the structure, we will come up with some of the video lectures in the coming week. But so we are not able to get what is the exact structure of the course journal and what should be the representation for that course journal. Huh. And because ultimately at the end we have to submit this course journal. Mm-hmm. So please, can you elaborate all this?
Okay. Are there any more questions? So one is about course journal.
No, sir.
Okay. So the question from RC 1281 is about structure of course journal. Now, a course journal is more or less similar to the class notes that students take in a regular classroom. But the only difference is that the course journal has more reflective entries of participating faculty's experience. Hence, there are no standard formats for the course journal. However, you are free to do your own structure. So if you actually look at course journal submitted in the discussion forum, a lot of people have done innovative structure of course journal. So somebody has done it in tabular form, somebody has split it across activities, somebody has used a theme to develop a course journal. So there are no hard and fast form for a course journal, simply because it is your own experience that you are noting down to a course journal. You can follow any structure as long as your course journal is understood by another student, because your course journal is primarily targeting another user, another colleague of yours, or the instructor, because they will be looking at these notes and understanding how much you have got from the FDP. So next, let me go to 1092 KIT College, Kolhapur.
Sir, my question is related to the animation which you have used in your first video lecture of first week.
Okay.
While presenting something, you are showing some designs using your hand and fingers. Teacher-student relation. What technology or software used, may I know, sir?
Okay. Are there any more questions, ma'am, from the center?
Is the technology used, is it open source, or that was the question, sir. Over to you,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. So, I was just consulting with my studio team over here, just to clarify whether my understanding is right. So, the question is, what was the software used for, fancy animations in my videos? So,
yes.
The quick answer is, they are known as video editors. It's called, the category of softwares are called video editors. For the current videos, we have used Adobe Premiere and Adobe After Effects.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Please note that there are open source softwares available for video editing, but it may not be as effective as a proprietary software like Adobe Premiere, or it depends. I mean, you will have to look at what all functionalities are being provided. So, for example, earlier there was a software called Windows Movie Maker. This used to come in Windows XP and its subsequent versions. This was also a video editing software, but what we could do was only, let's say, putting it in a box or different forms in which video can be edited, giving colors, making chroma tint, etc., etc.
Those were very impressive, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So I would pass on the credits to our studio team, who have done the entire process. Let me just tell you an approximate effort. 4 minutes of video, it took us nearly half day, so around 3 to 4 hours just to shoot the videos, and another 4 to 5 hours to prepare the FX and do the reviewing and other process. It's a very time consuming process.
We are fortunate for this, sir, getting all these things, material, resources, video, etc., sir.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir, on our behalf.
Yeah, thank you. So, let me now go to the next remote center, KK Wag 1008.
Sir, I am Chetna Kamlaskar from KK Wag. Sir, my question is very simple. When the discussion for the structure, understand it and...
Ma'am, your voice is breaking. So, let me rephrase the question and tell me whether it is my understanding is correct or not. So, it is about the structure of the discussion forum and how to navigate it, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so that is exactly what I started this session with. So, if you actually look into the menu of the discussion, you can see it has been arranged to multiple categories or tags have been given, like LXI week 1, LXI course journal, LXI web presence, there are general general discussions, there are also queries that has been posted in the discussion. So you can use any of these. So if you look at based on the type of query, let's say you have a query on course journal, what I would recommend is go to the exact section called LXI course journal and create a new post in it, so that others will understand that this is a query in the discussion forum under the course journal, and you can post the queries either as questions which you want answers to and general discussion topics. So by questions, what we mean is exactly questions that you are posing, like this, how to navigate, how to structure, where other peers will contribute to the answer and even the community TA will answer your queries. By discussion, it could be more generic discussion, let's say uploading your course journal, the link of the course journal, and getting reviews from your peers. So these could be classified as a discussion. So this is, I mean, it will take some time for you to understand, because every person's ICT, familiarity differs. It's just like how, so one analogy that I could give is, kids these days, let's say 1 to 2 year olds are able to do mobile swipes and download games easily using their father's or parents' mobile. Now this is like, they are also what we call them are digital natives. That means they are in a system where use of digital tools or ICT devices are very common. Now, for us to become a digital native, there is a learning curve for us, and there are no other shortcuts other than practice. So you will have to post discussions, get answer, go through the structure, etc., to clearly understand the discussion forum. I hope I have answered your question.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me now go to
Let
me now go to the next remote center. 1108 RC Patel, Shirpur.
Yes, my question is, as since discussion forum is a very important aspect.
Yes.
Still, what I have observed that we are not able to maintain the continuity during discussion.
Okay.
Since every time, although you have discussed various ways to find out those discussions in various categories, but still, once we get out of that discussion and do some other activity, that continuity is not maintained. So, can we have a system like notification which comes in Facebook? Somebody comment on my discussion so that I can continue further.
Okay.
And so one more. Yes.
Yeah, yeah. You can ask your second question.
Can you show some examples of good discussion which has taken place on our forum? Because we can't go through various pages. Hmm. There are 22, 26, 28 pages. Every time it is difficult to open those pages and find out the good discussion.
Okay. So,
can you show or display some good examples of discussion?
Okay. So, the question is about can there be a functionality of mail notifications for discussion forum? And second, can this be more structured, as in can there be tags wherein it is easily it could be easily navigated across the discussion forum? So the answer to the question is yes, we can have email notifications. So currently the OpenEDX version of that we are using for IIT Bombay X, it does not support, currently it does not support the mail notification feature. However, in the we are soon going to upgrade the IIT Bombay X software, and you will have mail notifications coming for discussions, just like how Facebook notifications come for each post or comments. Second thing regarding structuring, can there be another utility? So we are constrained by the current use of discussion forums in the current version of IIT Bombay X. However, what you can do is you yourself can practice organization and structured manner in which discussions can be taken place. So for example, in each discussion forum, we are giving you clear instructions that you have to post something about, let's say, course journal, and go and review two or three peers who have uploaded their course journal. Now, one way of doing it is seeing where course journal reviews are not available yet and replying back to the peer who has posted their discussion in the forum. Now, there needs to be, so in such a massive open online course, there is always going to be, it's always going to be chaotic to do the structuring, as at the same time you have a lot more participants. And so one way of maintaining the structure is to practice self-regulation, wherein you clearly do, if one person does the self-regulation and somebody else follows you, then overall the discussion forum will be more structured. I would also request the associate faculty from who are engaging in the discussion forum and who are going to be the mentors to motivate their mentees to practice organization while responding in discussion forum. So we'll hopefully have more clear instructions about participation in discussion forum. If the instructions are one problem due to which things are not clearly understood, we'll also take the help of associate faculty who are the community TAs in this particular course to ensure there is a structured manner in which discussion is happening.
One more question.
Yeah.
My question is that we had completed one activity with the WordPress.
Okay.
And we had also watched videos of Drupal. Hmm. So is there any activity relating to the Drupal, sir?
Currently, so the question is, are there activities related to Drupal? Apart from the assimilation quiz, there are no activities for Drupal currently, because Drupal makes it all the more confusing for first time users. Until and unless they are getting used to it, you may find little difficulties on how to use Drupal. But however, let me tell you that Drupal is a fast emerging open source software that is becoming really powerful content management system with lot of functionalities like roles, authentication, and several new features. So in the future versions of this FTP, we may think of using Drupal instead of WordPress. WordPress is a simpler version of open source website creation. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me now go to Professor Fatak, who is joining us from BMS College. Good afternoon, Professor Fatak.
Good afternoon, and good afternoon to all the participants. I will just take 5 minutes to tell you that I am so happy to be at this place. This is one of the oldest institutions in the country. The BMS College has been our partner for donkey's years. And most importantly, it was one of the best institutions in terms of sending a very large number of top performers in the first FDP that we had conducted. I had the privilege of meeting some of them along with their senior leadership when we had organized a workshop in Mumbai. And I'm so happy to be here with my coordinator. Curiously, he's from biotechnology field. You can see a very large number of participants here. I am told that there are some teachers who are from non-engineering or non-technical psychology. So we have somebody from psychology. Do we have somebody who is teaching at 11, 12 standard? I wish there were some more people. Oh, there are some. Wonderful. So here is a very mixed group of people who are all wanting to benefit from use of technology for the students whom they will teach in diverse fields. It is not just the diverse fields, but the diverse ages as well. My own ambition is that someday even the primary and middle school students should be using this technology, and most certainly all working professionals should also use this to benefit themselves. We are making a beginning. As I keep saying, you are going to be the pioneers of what future India education will look like. And to that end, I would like to compliment you. I would take this opportunity to answer one question which was just asked about Drupal. So while we do not have any explicit content in Drupal right now, but we are doing something which you should all be happy to note and which is connected with Drupal. All of you use IIT Bombay X. Now that's a platform which we run on a cloud. All of you are totally familiar with it. Now our intention is that just like many colleges use Moodle, we would like colleges also to use the same online platform. So we are now developing what we call a hybrid distribution built on IIT Bombay X, which can be installed on local servers in your colleges, and you can actually offer online courses and blended or hybrid courses to your own students on the campus who do not have to depend on internet. They will be able to access your servers using local area campus network. And that distribution is being built in IIT Bombay as we speak, which has at the core OpenEdX, and as the front end, we are using Drupal. So we will also be conducting an online or blended short course for technical staff members of various colleges if they are interested in using these and other technologies. Because one mistake that we have made always in our higher education and particularly technical education is that we have unnecessarily distinguished between teaching faculty and technical staff. I got a glimpse of that just now. My favorite axiom has been, even in IIT, that when we conduct laboratories and when students have problems, it is not the so-called teaching staff like us who are able to solve their problems quickly, but it is the technical staff which solve their problems. In IIT Bombay, we give a lot of respect to the technical staff. They are also not called faculty because a faculty member has to have a PhD, research publications, etc. But the point is, in this game of using technology effectively for education, we will need increasing participation by the technical staff. And therefore, it is absolutely important that we, the conventional teaching faculty, and our technical staff in respective colleges work in tandem, work together, so that the entire infrastructure that is made available for teaching learning processes works very well. I digress slightly, but the point I'm making is that this distribution, which is of course open source distribution with contribution from IIT Bombay, comprising of OpenEdX base, comprising of what we call the MIS or information system, and the hybrid additions that we have made to the platform, plus the Drupal front end, will be released as a new IIT Bombay X avatar in January, and simultaneously a loadable version which can be installed on your local servers will also be released. Each individual institution, just like you modify Moodle today to put your own college name and other thing, similarly you can take this installation, customize it to represent your own institute, and in future you would be able to run your own online courses First, of course, for the benefit of your own students, but who knows, once you have a good online course, you can offer it on Swayam, you can offer it to other people. So that is where the technology directions are moving. I once again thank a large number of participants here and my coordinator here in BMS College. Over to you.
Yeah. Thank you, Professor Phatak. So I hope the participants really are understanding the vision of IIT Bombay in improving the teaching learning process across the country and the scale at which we are trying it. So I would also at this moment thank all the associate faculty who are participating from the different remote centers and are assisting us, the IIT Bombay team, in this larger vision. So I hope that many of you from the remote centers across the remote centers will join us as associate faculty when the new IIT Bombay X will come in January, and where we will be having more such FDP programs. So FDP 101X and FDP 201X will be continuing across the year, wherein we may also try to do multiple FDPs at the same time based on the participation that we have in the courses. So these are all larger visions, and as Professor Phatak rightly said, all of you are the pioneers in this particular venture along, and you are currently, so even the participation from different teachers across the remote centers, it is actually contributing towards this large effort. And I again thank all of the people involved in this particular course, and I also thank Professor Phatak. Let me now take another question from the remote center. This is from 1316 Dronacharya College of Engineering.
This is Dr. Aditi Paul from Dronacharya College of Engineering, Greater Noida.
Yeah.
Sir, from my participants, there is a question that yesterday's sessions, some assignments were given from some sessions, especially on Professor Phatak's session, right?
Yes.
So he has got some audio video problem during those sessions, and participants are not able to answer those assignments.
Okay.
So my request, or you can say query, is that can we have those videos again?
So please note that, so the query is regarding the sessions, the videos of sessions that were conducted yesterday. Many participants, due to technical issues, were not able to completely understand the session, and there were some issues at some of the remote centers. So what we have done is, there is a YouTube channel for the studio team, IIT Bombay X studio, and this was actually shared in chat yesterday. What I'll do is, I'll at the end of the session, I'll share the studio channel link once again, where you can actually go through the sessions at your own convenience. And by tomorrow, I'll have the same uploaded in the IIT Bombay X system against each session. So you can actually connect from directly use the IIT Bombay X course for accessing these videos. Let me now take some questions that have been coming up in the questions tab. So the first query, which has been upvoted three times, the query is initially from ME Societies IMCC Pune. We have two queries. Do we have to upload the course journal and the website link of WordPress? How do we effectively apply reflection sport and quiz activity using LMS for a class of size 60? Let me answer the first question. Uploading the course journal as a file is not required at this moment. We'll be giving specific instruction to you, wherein you can upload your course journal into your own WordPress site, and you can share the link of your WordPress site in the discussion forum, as well as there is going to be a specific assignment in week 4 where we'll actually look into website creation. So there will be a user goal, like what Professor Sundar told yesterday, there will be a user goal that we will be defining, and we would be asking you to create upload materials that you have in this FDP to answer the user good. So I'll now mark this as done. So CDAC Noida has a question. In the discussion forum, how can one search for those specific questions that I would like to follow? Let us say I have already selected a question and follow it. So all you have to do, the question is about following in discussion forum. You are following it, and within the menu of discussion forum, there is a row known as posts I am following. Just click on posts I am following, and you will be able to see the posts that you are that you have already marked as the ones to follow. In addition, what you can also do is use the search window, the search tab, and if you know the words, so it's not just the username. If you know the username of the person who has posted or specific words in the question, you can type it in the discussion forum and it will automatically fetch the discussion associated with that particular question. So this is a question from Selvam College. At time, how many mentees and mentor can connect? We are trying to ensure that all mentees and mentors can connect simultaneously. This is approximately 40 to 50 mentees connecting to a single mentor. It will take us some time to configure the group and put it up in the AVU, as it is a manual process. But however, we are positive that by the start of week 4, we will have all the mentor-mentee groupings done and configured user IDs for all the participants. Okay, there is another question again by Dronacharya College. Should we upload the video in the WordPress for week 2 assignment? The answer is no. This is a practice activity where you had to, so the LBDs are ungraded activities that you have to do as practice. Only thing is, you will have to embed videos which are not copyright protected, and carefully select these videos from YouTube or other video sharing sites like Vimeo or other websites. Okay, there is a question from Mangalyatan University. How can we download Moodle? Downloading Moodle, all you have to go to is the Moodle main site, moodle.org. There is a section called Downloads. You can download the latest version of Moodle from the Moodle website, moodle.org. So now let me take some questions from RCs. So this is KIT College of Engineering, Gurgaon, Haryana. RC1209.
Good afternoon, sir. Professor Pathak talked about academic ethics and integrity in initial videos. I want to know about more about that in context to online mode.
Okay, so this is regarding academic ethics and integrity while doing online courses. So this is almost similar as to a regular face-to-face classrooms. Plagiarism is strictly not allowed. Plagiarism as in you take materials from others without their prior consent or permission. You should not copy from your friends, and you should always acknowledge or cite the source from which you are taking the resources. So proper citation has to be given, and basically avoid plagiarism. These are some of the major guidelines for maintaining academic ethics. One more thing that you should do at your end is, whenever you are creating a, let's say, a course journal or a website, what you have to do is put these resources under Creative Commons, so that other faculty or other let's say students of you can freely use these resources without worrying about copyright. Next is 1172, Theme College of Engineering.
Sir, actually, Sahasrabuddhi sir, session was excellent.
Okay.
But just, sir, please, can we get a presentation sample which is related to any subject, maybe computer engineering, mechanical engineering, or any subject, so that we can get, we can easily prepare a PowerPoint presentation for our specified subject. Maybe it may contain tables, graphs, and text. Can we get?
Okay, So the question is, are there available, what do you say, existing materials regarding slides with good presentations for different subjects? So one thing is, you will, so these are going to be created in a crowdsourcing manner. So if you actually look at the WordPress sites of the mentors who are part of these, who are part of this FTP, you will see a lot of resources being uploaded by the mentors. So one possible way of looking at these resources is, what do you say, looking at the mentors resources. Another thing is, we will definitely try to create an activity where all of you will be creating one slide or a few slides within your domain, adhering to the guideline, presentation guidelines that Dr. Sameer Sahasrabuddhi had given in the earlier session. This activity will come in week 5 of this course. Let me now go to RC1058, Goa College of Engineering.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
I had actually two questions. One was on discussion forum, but already you answered that question regarding the course journal.
Okay.
Last week I had put my course journal in my website, mm-hmm. and I was a little scared whether it was seen by our peers.
Okay.
You already gave the answer for that. And second one is about regarding mentor-mentee interaction.
Okay.
As the semester is going on, when you view the timing, and if we are having class hours, that time you say, yesterday, what we came to know is after that duration, you are closing down that. So what okay. to do?
Okay, and so the question is regarding, so the first, if I am correct, your first question has been answered, right? Regarding course journal.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the second question regarding AVU interactions across different time slots. So what we are planning is that we'll have a longer time window available for a individual interaction. You can log into the system, let's say across a 3-hour time period, and basically you will have to interact with your mentor at least once in the let's say in the coming 9 to 10 days or 14 days of the course, the final 2 weeks of the course. The exact modalities of interaction are going to be provided, and if AVU is not, so we will keep the AVU server up. So it was only because the interaction finished at 5, around 4:45 yesterday, that we had closed the AVU presentation. With the mentors, what we will do is, we will keep the class open for a longer period of time, wherein you will be able to see the mentors in the AVU classroom. 1269.
My question is, how to find my journal or ID in discussion forum? Find a easier way.
So the query is how to find the course journal. Basically, what you can do is, you can give keywords like your name and course journal, etc., to identify the exact post where you have actually shared your course journal. You can use the search tab and also select the post I am following menu in the discussion forum to clearly see your course journal. Let me now go to RC1015, Vidya Pratishtan College.
So we are having a few doubts. First, regarding the website, WordPress, we are having it, but can we link this with our institute's website?
Okay, if I understand the query correctly, you want to link some of the resources from another website to your current WordPress. So just ensure that the resources that you have created in the other website are available in free and open or in Creative Commons before linking it. If it is your own, what you can do in addition is, make sure that these becomes Creative Commons in the before linking it completely.
Sir, actually it is not the question, but the request from my side that workshop coordinators can't access that material or whatever that quizzes are there. So is it possible to give the access to the workshop coordinators so that they can be involved as a participant also?
Okay.
And second thing is that the participant performance is also not monitored we can't see it, so we can't have that monitoring also. Is it possible for that or some strategy, different strategy?
Okay, so the question is, can there be mechanisms of monitoring participants' performance by workshop coordinator? And also second thing, can the workshop coordinator have access to the resources in the FDP? Now, the resources in the FDP are available in free and open source, and you can actually get the links from your participants from your college. Regarding participation in the FDP, please note that due to logistical issues that we had announced the final date, then registered participants into the course across 2 to 3 weeks, will not be able to give workshop coordinator access to the course as a participant. However, what you can actually do is there are going to be upcoming series of FTPs that we will start from January. You can actually participate in any one of them and be the participant.
I belong to a management institute.
Okay.
And the question is not related to this particular FTP.
Okay.
In general, related to IIT Bombay X. Whenever I am searching for management oriented programs, courses are there on the website, which are management related, like basics of accounting or management fundamentals, economics kind of. But if we want to enroll for that one, so that time the message comes that is enrollment by by invitation only.
Okay.
We cannot register directly there.
Okay, so are you talking of IIT Bombay X courses or other courses in general?
IIT Bombay X, on IIT Bombay X website only.
Okay.
These courses used to be there, but that is, I think, interlinked with the EDX and from IIMBX.
No, so the thing is, so all these are examples of different, so edX is a different entity, IIT Bombay X is a different online learning entity. I am Bangalore X is a complete a different entity. Only common thing is IIT Bombay X and I am Bangalore X uses the same version of OpenEDX, and so each of the MOOC has their own rules of participation. So for example, in this particular FDP, it was required that all participants register by a particular time in the NMEICT portal, where they have to provide identity card, proofs of participation, etc., etc. So only those people will be allowed to participate in these courses. So the notification for this will come in NMEICT website. So the website is it.iitb.ac.in/NMEICT, where you can see workshop announcements as one of the tab. So what you have to do is regularly do a follow up of this, monitor this particular space. And all new courses will be announced, all the IIT Bombay X courses will be announced in this particular page.
Okay.
Let me now go to 1256 Sri Datta Institute of Engineering and Science.
Sir, very good afternoon. Myself, I'm Radhika from Sri Datta Engineering College. So my question is about we are few faculties we didn't register, so but we are very much interested to interact in this program, but if we are not registered, we can't do any assignment. So is there any facility for unregistered people
currently? So that's what I said in the previous question. Currently, unregistered participants, we cannot have activities in IIT Bombay X. Or what you can actually get is the links of video from other participants to understand what the material is about and have a broad understanding of how the FDP is being carried out.
Okay. And one more question, we would like to interact with Pertex more, so we would like to know about FDP things by Pertex.
Okay, so I will definitely puts this to Professor Phatak. We are actually planning to visit several remote centers during the FDPs, after the FDP, etc. So I'll definitely ask Professor Phatak to mark your institution as one possible venue when he is actually traveling towards Hyderabad next time.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me now go to 1228 Loyola ICAM College of Engineering and Technology.
Sir, I have few questions. Sir, is there any criteria for course journal evaluation posted by participants? And my second question.
Yeah, please go on with the question.
Yeah, in future, is there any possibility of where we can able to see the A-view interaction on our own system?
So there are two questions. One is regarding the review criteria for course journal, and the second is watching the A-view interaction in your own system. So my answer to the first question is the criteria for review of course journal has been provided in that particular week itself, where we had looked at three aspects of course journal. How structured it is, what is the level of reflection that is being posted by the participant in the course journal. However, please note that this is an ungraded activity. Currently, we have not put, we have not factored in the reviews that are coming to these course journals, because there is going to be wide variation in the way your peer is assessing these course journals. So today, Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe gave you guidelines on peer review, how to use a rubric and do the evaluation. Similarly, the same rubrics were used in core journal as well. Basically, you will have to follow the rubric criteria to evaluate the course journal. Your second question regarding AVU in a local system, it is still available because it's a, as I told yesterday, it's a free and open source software. It is easily downloadable. The only condition is that you should be able to connect to a server which can support the bandwidth that is being that is required for AVU interaction. So your video, so as I speak, my video and audio are traveling through internet as data packets, and it is reaching all the remote centers. Now, if there isn't sufficient data bandwidth, then there is going to be issues at your end in watching this video and audio. So this is typically what we call the losses in data packet. So it's like you have a big pipe and you are actually trying to pull lot of material through that pipe, and somewhere it gets stuck and it does not proceed correctly to the intended location. Now, this bandwidth is the essential requirement for viewing the audios and videos clearly. And this is what we mentioned in today's morning's interaction, that if the audio video is not working, then we'll have to check the local institution's bandwidth and the facilities provided in the institution. Because IIT Bombay is successfully transmitting the same video audio to many remote centers at the same time. So places where there are issues, then they will have to check the local bandwidth and the local infrastructure to see whether they are complying to the AVU standards.
Yes, sir. Sir, one last question I have. In assimilation assessment, in case of a question which has more than two or three options, maybe one statement may be correct. In case someone is going to correct only one statement as answer, suppose the right answer may be two or three statements, in case, how we will grade such a question?
So I think it has been mentioned in the assimilation, I mean places where there are more than one answers are correct. Until and unless all the answers are identified by the participant, the current IIT Bombay X system will not accept that answer as correct. So basically what I am saying is, there is currently the multiple choice options or the checkbox options do not have partial answers. So if and only if you make all the answers correct, will you be able to get full points for it. Let me now move to center RC1063.
Yeah, sir. Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Myself, Santosh Nagarguje from Modern College of Engineering, Pune. So I would like to ask one question, that you said, or our third big activity, we are having Moodle LMS.
Yes.
And also you are taking your all workshops, activities on IIT Bombay X, which is based on EDX, Open EDX.
Okay.
So we know that Open EDX and Moodle LMS that we can use, that they are open source and freely available. But the main problem is that if we want to use at our college level, we have to buy very high-end servers, high-end machines for that, and we have to publish it online using domain. But unfortunately, there are so many colleges nowadays that they are not able to, or they are not ready to provide money, or they are not ready to make investment in that infrastructure. And like us, the teachers are, our faculties are very much interested to use these new technologies for the good sake of our students. So I would like to ask with that, is IIT Bombay is going to provide a portal on which we teacher can create our subdomains, and we can create our own Moodle server or open EDX server for our students?
Okay, the question is, can there be open EDX setup at our end, which can be given access to other engineering college or other colleges? See, Swayam is a portal. So my quick answer is, though it is possible, but we have another portal called Swayam, which has been inaugurated nationally, and it is a national level portal where people can use that portal to host online, I mean, offer online courses. I will definitely speak to Professor Phatak regarding your request, wherein teachers can use, let's say, IIT Bombay X. Let me just add one simple thing, where faculty can currently use IIT Bombay X courses in a blended format, or what we call hybrid format. So we have this particular offerings of courses to wherein each teacher can enroll their students in the MOOC, and they will be able to monitor the students' performance. So these are called blended MOOCs, or now we will be terming them as hybrid MOOCs. So once IIT, the new version of IIT Bombay X comes in, we are hopeful that several such courses can be offered from our facility for which can benefit teachers and students equally. Let me now move to Shastra University, 1140.
Good afternoon, JK. This is Ram Kumar.
Yeah, hi, Ram Kumar.
Coordinator of the workshop.
Okay.
First of all, I would like to give a kind of a big salute to IIT Bombay and this team for doing a kind of a fantastic, inspiring job, in fact, the past 50 days, in fact. So it's the kind of passion you exude in this particular job is, in fact, really inspiring all the faculty members who are sitting here. And there are so many questions we have right now. In fact, every faculty member is interested in posing a question. I've identified a few members here, and start with Professor K. Shekhar will be posing the first question.
This is one technical question in regard with Drupal. As such, Drupal is one CMS content management system.
Yes.
Where we are having one number of software components. Suppose we want to gauge each and every software component, rather I like to say to gauge about the quality of service, such as reliability. How to gauge? Is there any such software is available?
Okay, so the question is about what you say, reliability of the softwares is one thing. Can you ask the second question?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello, ma'am.
Hello. Sir, how to create a transcript file for video? If there is any tool, or we have to type manually using transcript for the video.
Okay. Transcripts for video. So, if I am not mistaken, you are asking about transcripts for video. Okay. Are there any other questions from the center?
Yes, sir. Completed our personal log, web logs we have completed. So, in that, whether we can change the theme after design the page, whether the theme can be changed, any facility over there,
okay,
how that can be done.
Okay, so themes, can there be themes, different themes possible? So there are three questions from Shastra University. Let me answer it one by one. So one is regarding, yeah, please post your question.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Nandini, assistant professor in English. At the outset, we'd like to extend our gratitude to the total crew of IITs.
Okay.
And especially Professor Patak for his vivid, explanations and his clarity of thoughts.
Okay.
Definitely take him as a role model, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
And thank you for making the digital immigrants like us, to get involved towards ICT.
Thank you.
Move on to the question. It's a general question. See, if it is in a regular class, when we come across a student, when we find a student disinterested in the lesson, we may switch over to some other topic of his interest. Is it possible in incorporating ICT in classroom?
So there are four questions from Shastra University. I'll answer them one by one. So the first question is regarding reliability, softwares that can check the reliability. So there are performance testing softwares that actually look at various parameters of the software that needs to be tested. So in fact, even for IIT Bombay X, we do our performance testing at our end and see whether it can handle loads, whether it is reliable, etc. At our end. So it depends on the software that you want to test reliability. Those kind of softwares are available. You will have to check in the web for specifically for the software that you want to check reliability for. The second thing, are there softwares for creating transcripts? Yes, there are. There are some proprietary softwares available. Another way is actually upload video into YouTube and create auto transcripts. Those YouTube by itself will generate a auto transcript which can be downloaded, and you can correct you can correct the specific portions where there are errors, and you can re-upload the same transcript to YouTube. Regarding the question on themes of WordPress, yes, themes can be changed, but some of the themes are paid. There are certain free themes available in WordPress. One is Bootstrap that was used. You will have to explore the themes menu from the dashboard. And there was a final question. Use of ICT in classroom to make students interesting. The generic answer is yes, ICT can be easily integrated into the classroom. However, as a teacher, what you have to be really careful is not just about the technology, the pedagogy that you are using along with the technology has to be carefully designed, and so that user experience is positive through which they will continue using ICT. So technology integration by teachers is a very well researched area. If you actually look into journal databases like Scopus or let's say Google Scholar, you will see a lot of papers on the idea of technology integration by teachers. So this is RC1200, IES College, Madhya Pradesh.
I want to ask questions about mentor and mentoring system.
Can you repeat the question? I heard some portions of it, but I am not able to completely hear it.
Secondary vocational education. What are the consequences of an ICT integrated curriculum in secondary vocational education?
Okay, let me repeat the question and tell me whether I have heard it correct. You want to understand what are the implications of a ICT enabled engineering curriculum. Am I right?
Okay.
So see, the vision that we have is that more teachers will use ICT in the coming days and use it effectively within, let's say, not just engineering curriculum. As Professor Fatak said, even in schools, the facility will be provided for students and teachers alike where they can use ICT. So the vision of ICT-led curriculum is very solid. One important thing that you have to note while making any curriculum ICT enabled is you have to be very careful about using the technology and its pedagogy effectively within the classroom. Otherwise, what will happen is that you will not have the same effectiveness that you could actually get from the same ICT device. Let me now take a question from Professor Ram Mega Institute 1193.
Sir, in Moodle,
whether we can identify the student, those who have appeared for the assignment, test or quizzes.
Okay, so the question is whether we can identify the specific students who have accessed an assignment or a quiz. Yes, every learning management system provides this feature of monitoring the performance of the student. It is an important part which differentiates a learning management system from a content management system. Let me now go to RC1313, KS Rangasamy College.
Regarding the discussion forum, we are not able to interact in the discussion forum since it is showing error from today morning itself.
Okay, so the
how
question is...
How do we complete the reflection quiz?
Okay, so the question is, people are unable to access discussion forum in IIT Bombay X as of now. What we are going to do is, we are going to extend the deadline of all the graded activities that were set to today to tomorrow midnight. Hopefully we'll have the system up and running by tomorrow morning, from after which you will be able to access it much more easily.
Regarding WordPress, WordPress creation, you said about WP admin accessing the dashboard.
Okay.
So instead of changing the themes and fonts in, through the dashboard, we can even customize without going to the dashboard by accessing our site itself, right? Is it necessary to alter the themes and the fonts only through dashboard?
Okay, so dashboard is one place where you can easily access it. So the moment you want to change the theme, dashboard is the place where you can do the management of the site, this is what we call site management. That can be done from the dashboard. So for WordPress, the dashboard is in WP admin. Can you tell me how you will do without accessing the dashboard?
While accessing our website itself, we come across the domains. So below the domains, there is a customize option. In that customize option, we are getting all those menus and pages where we can even choose our order of the pages. Rather than going to the admin, it is very easier in this way.
Okay, so what you are seeing here are what we call templates. Templates for the website. So there are ready-made templates available which will have multiple features, and you are actually seeing it. But if you want to create your own template, you still have to go to dashboard to create your own themes, font sizes, etc. So it is like when you open MS Word, all the font styles are already given in the document. So similarly, when you go to WordPress, there are specific templates available which you can take and configure your website.
From our side, sir.
Yeah.
Regarding that transcript which you said that we have to upload it using YouTube, but we are required to do it only in WordPress, not with the help of YouTube. How it is possible to have the transcript of our video in WordPress itself?
So, first of all, there is no requirement that the transcript has to be there in the video. So, we haven't started the video creation process. It will come in week 4 only. The current activity was to find a video from any of the file sharing sites and embed it in the WordPress. So, it is not required that the video should have a transcript. Only thing is, ensure that you write a little about the video and how it is. So it's just like a blog post. You have to create a post which is through which you will understand what the video is about. That's all. Okay, let me now go to the next remote center. PSG College of Engineering, Coimbatore.
We have two questions related to mentee-mentor interaction.
Okay.
My first question is, how do a mentee come to know the interaction schedule? My second question is, suppose a mentee missed the schedule, how the interaction content can be accessed later?
Okay, the question is regarding mentor-mentee interaction. So what we'll do is, we'll be publishing, IIT Bombay will be publishing the slots. So since this is the first time we are trying out, this time around we'll be publishing the slots for interaction from our end. We'll be informing the mentors and mentees. Suppose that an interaction has not happened, at that point of time, we will look at other means through which the mentors can support the mentees. So I'll be discussing this with Professor Phatak tomorrow, and you will get a detailed email giving you guidelines regarding mentor-mentee interaction.
So one more general question.
Yeah.
As a participant of this FDP, everything, all our education are outcome-based learning.
Okay.
As a participant, we would like to know the skill set or a skills after completing the course, what skill set we need to acquire after the completion of this course.
Okay, the question is regarding the outcomes of the course. So if you actually see the about the course document, the learning objectives of the course has already been given in the about the course. So that is the first document that you have to read before starting the course, where we have clearly mentioned what is expected from the students, what are the broader objectives or outcomes of FDP 101X and also of FDP 201X.
We know the outcomes. As a participant, what I or any participant should acquire the skills, whether our presentation skill or communication skill or everything. So is there any skill sets which is to be acquired after the completion of?
So basically the skill that you require at the end of FDP 101 is sensitization towards various ICT tools and its effective use in teaching learning. And at the end of FDP 201, you will have how to use each tool effectively. So the pedagogy is to be used effectively. So the skill that you are actually looking at is the learning design skill of the teacher.
Yes, sir, we have one more question.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Rajamogna from PSG Tech.
Yeah, tell me.
I am requesting you to ask Professor Phatak to visit our campus, sir, because we are very eager to interact with him, sir. Please convey this information to him.
So definitely, yes, I will convey the information to Professor Phatak. As and when Professor Phatak reaches Coimbatore or is passing through Coimbatore, I will ask him to make sure that he visits. I'll request him to visit your institute once. Thank you. Symbiosis Institute, RC1190.
Sir, I thank you very much for conducting this FDP. And this has really inspired me to go for my own course designing and delivering it. Is it possible to do it with IIT BX?
So that is what you are actually doing. You are doing this FDP in IIT BX itself. You are not using any other platform.
My question is, if I design my own course for my student,
okay.
Can I? There are many courses which are not available right now on IIT BX, which I suppose for on the economics there is no course available, on research methodology there is no course available. So if I design it, can I deliver it through the platform of IIT BX?
So currently we have not a policy which says that other faculty can offer courses in IIT BX or IIT Bombay X. However, I'll talk to Professor Phatak because these are edu MOOCs or educational MOOCs where you want a particular course content to be visible to a larger audience. So the modus operandi has to be clearly chalked out. And Swayam portal is already available. So we'll have to see how this can be better operationalized. Definitely across the end of these two FDPs by December, we'll have, let's say, more understanding of how this could be done through IIT Bombay X.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. So now RC1259.
Sir, my question is regarding the current scenario of web crimes. So we have created a very simple website, each of us have created.
Okay.
So what about the security of these websites? Whether these websites can get easily hacked or misused?
Okay, so this is a tangential topic that each participant should be aware of. Yes, every website has its own associated security threats. So you will have to look at the best practices to avoid let's say hacking by different agencies. There was a course in IIT Bombay offered by the computer science department on let's say improving the security and on network security and cryptography. Do attend courses like these in MOOCs as well as which are coming in QIP or CEP mode to understand more about security related issues related to websites. Currently in the scope of this FDP, this is not exactly there. However, we'll in the next version, we'll definitely look at including these aspects as well. Currently, we are looking at only plagiarism aspect of it. We'll definitely consider security related issues in the upcoming versions of the FDP.